Good evening, everyone. We welcome you to the 4th Annual PawSox Hall of Fame Induction Ceremony, presented by Narragansett Bay Insurance Company. And what an honor it is today to welcome back to Pawtucket, Rhode Island, one of the greatest pitchers the game of baseball has ever known. We just cannot help but rattle off some of the awards and spellbinding numbers that reflect one of the most outstanding careers in the history of our national pastime. He was the most valuable player in the American League. The winner of the Cy Young Award not once, not twice, not three times, but seven different times. Six of them in the American League and one in the National League. No one in the game of baseball today can compare to his 118 complete games, his 46 complete game shutouts, his nearly 5,000 innings pitched. How about his 4,672 strikeouts in those 4,916 and two-thirds innings pitched? And how about walking only one-third as many as he struck out? For many of us, two games stand out in his 24-year Major League career, when he set a Major League record and then tied his own record with the unbelievable total of 20 strikeouts in each of those games. He is one of the greatest pitchers ever to play the game. And before that amazing Major League career started, he was a marvel right here at McCoy Stadium in Pawtucket. With the PawSox in 1984, he struck out 50 hitters in 46 and two-thirds innings, while fashioning, get this, a 1.93 ERA, before quickly getting the call up to Boston. Yes, Pawtucket, Rhode Island was the launching pad of our Rocket Man. So now, let us welcome the guest of honor, accompanied by his beautiful wife, Debbie, and their longtime friend and resident of Rhode Island, Anthony Manzo from Anthony's Jewelers. Welcome number 21, Roger Clemens.
Russ.
Now, as you can imagine, a number of dignitaries, friends, and teammates have come to join him on this occasion. It's our honor to begin by welcoming the president of the International League, all the way from Ohio, the birthplace of our inductee. Welcome back, Randy Mobley. He is accompanied by the Red Sox Hall of Famer, who presided over this extraordinary era of World Series championships, now also the principal owner and chairman of the PawSox, and the chairman of the Jimmy Fund, a favorite charity of our honoree. Welcome, Larry Lucchino. He's here together with PawSox president, Dr. Charles Steinberg. And our sponsors from NBIC, President Tim Mora and Vice President Dave Deacon. Next, we welcome a friend of our inductee who is the famed Play Lady with Children at the Jimmy Fund, where our honoree has been a devoted, committed volunteer. Welcome, Lisa Sherber. Joining them is the manager of the PawSox, who himself will be enshrined into the International League Hall of Fame right here on this field tomorrow night, Billy McMillan. And the PawSox hitting coach, who was a catcher on the 1986 American League champions, and the catcher of that historic first 20 strikeout game, a friend of our inductee for more than 30 years. Welcome two-time All-Star Rich Gedman. And we have another member of the Red Sox Hall of Fame, who today is still evaluating talent on the PawSox for the big club. Welcome, always, Tommy Harper. They are joined by one of your favorite Red Sox stars, a Rhode Island resident, and a friend and teammate of our inductee on the American League champions of 1986, Oil Can Boy.
Came through the line while we were waiting 3.5 hours to meet Roger Clemens and took pictures.
And we welcome one of the only men in history who got to live in his hometown year-round while managing both the PawSox and the Red Sox with our inductee as his ace. He won the American League East in 1988 and again in 1990. Let's hear some words of welcome from Walpole Joe, Red Sox and PawSox Hall of Famer. Here he is, Joe Morgan.
This is a good show. Good to see you. This is for you right here.
Yeah. Welcome, folks. And Roger and Debbie, congratulations on your great night here. And thanks for making me a lot of money, buddy. The first time I saw Roger was down in Texas when he was in college, and the Red Sox sent me down there to scout him. Well, his manager, Gustafson, when I went down to see him, I asked him, when is Roger gonna pitch? And then he said, well, his arm's a little tight, so it's probably 2 or 3 days. Then I remembered that college coaches don't like scouts too much because they take their kids and they don't get 4 years out of them. I can say I don't blame them there one bit. So Calvin Giraldi was pitching that night, and he looked very good. Now, after the game, I was sitting in the stands waiting for the cars to get out of the parking lot. I saw a little scuffling around in the dugout, and out comes Roger with the glove and a catcher. Well, I watched him warm up, and then he got serious and threw some pretty good fastballs and a breaking ball. And I said, boy, I'm going home right now. There's no need of looking anymore. This guy's gonna be a big boy in the big leagues. So, in my first game, when I was named interim manager, I had a cinch winner because it was Roger's turn to start the ball rolling, and he did. So, when the club won 12 straight games, that made me the winningest interim manager in baseball history. And I had played for the guy that had the record, Fred Haney in Milwaukee with 11. And they were like the Red Sox. They had a real good team too. They had guys like Henry Aaron, Warren Spahn, Matthews, but they just weren't winning. And away went Charlie Grimm and Haney came on, they won 11 games. What kind of a pitcher was Roger when he first got here? He had a great fastball, and when he threw it up high, people awed about how great it was. But Roger's fastball knee high was nearly unhittable. It looked like it picked up speed the last 10 feet. I would say it was sometime in August when a right-hand batter finally hit a home run on a low fastball. I think it was Chet Lemon. And I told Roger that, and he said, well, the count was 3-1, and I wasn't about to walk him, so I just laid it in there and let him hit it. Do you remember that, Roger? I doubt it. Roger had, in those days, what I thought was the best slider I had seen. Really a good pitch. And then he came up with the split and also perfected that and became the great power hitter, power pitcher that I knew he would be. So good luck in the future, Roger, Debbie, and your whole family. And thank everybody for coming tonight.
Now, before we hear from our inductee himself, Larry Lucchino and Dr. Charles will unveil some of these beautiful gifts that will be presented to the greatest pitcher many of us have ever seen. Now, these are two cases. Roger's gonna come on over. These two cases, each holding 20 baseballs, and each baseball bears the name of a strikeout victim from that 20 strikeout game in 1986 and that 20 strikeout game in 1996. With names like Hall of Famer Alan Trammell, manager Brad Ausmus, and the head of the MLB Players Association, Tony Clark, yes, all of them are immortalized in their futile effort to overcome the dominance of this great right-hander. Now moving over to my left, we also have two framed beautiful posters that not only commemorate those two nights, but also display the gaudy array of awards and numbers that help us understand just how extraordinary was the career of the newest member of the PawSox Hall of Fame. All right, here to receive his plaque and officially be enshrined into the Pawtucket Red Sox Hall of Fame. I'm gonna wait for the picture. Ladies and gentlemen, won't you please welcome number 21. Here he is, Roger Clemens.
Thank you. Thank you all. Appreciate it, guys. Thanks, guys. Appreciate everybody being here. It's always great to come back and see so many familiar faces. I think the coolest thing for me is over my 24 years, without a doubt, were the guys that I got to play with, my teammates and my coaches and my managers throughout. Like Joe said, coming down to Texas to watch me out of the gate, Danny Doyle signing me to the Red Sox. When I came out of the University of Texas, we beat Alabama, and I had the opportunity to be, you know, come and play for the Boston Red Sox. And what a special journey that was, guys. I appreciate it so much. It was pretty cool. I'll give you a quick, because I don't want to keep these guys hanging. They got a ball game to play, but it was pretty cool. I come from the College World Series pitching in front of about 15, 20,000. The Red Sox signed me and sent me to a place, said, "You're going to Winter Haven, Florida." I didn't know where it was at. I was like, "Where are you sending me?" "Winter Haven, Florida." I get to Winter Haven, Florida. There's 11 people in the stands. You can see the guy in the stands yelling at you when you threw a ball, when I walked a guy or something. So then I hit New Britain. And fortunately, that team, we rock and roll there and ended up winning a championship in New Britain. Then I had an opportunity to come here to Pawtucket and play right here in front of you fans on my way to Boston. So I really appreciate it. So again, my teammates that are here now, my teammates that are up in Boston, that live outside of Boston, the guys there. I do a little work for the Astros now, but I work with a bunch of the teams that I played with, different guys. When they call and ask about certain things, try and share my knowledge, because that's what happened for me as a young 21-year-old when I came to Boston. I had some fantastic teammates, some veteran teammates that welcomed me with open arms coming in there. And you know, once I got to the big leagues, I never wanted to look back. So it was a big, big privilege for me. I will say real quick, I just got done talking to my battery mate over here, Richie Gedman. Geddy's the best, I'm telling you. This guy got me on the map when we punched out 20, and then Bruce Hurst gave me the nickname the Rocket, and we never looked back from there. So we got it done, Geds. And let me tell you what, I threw a heavy ball, a very hard two-seam fastball at times, and I wore my man's thumb out a lot, so, and then he had to go hit, so, love that, love Geddy, he's the best. So, quick shout out, everybody, listen to me real quick. I'm here, I wanted to be in Idaho because, as you know, one of our teammates passed away a little while back, Billy Buckner. We love Billy Buckner. I'm so happy that we do have a few of our current teammates that when we played together with Billy Buck, they're actually going to be at his celebration of life tomorrow in Idaho. And we read something to him about being great teammates, and Billy Buckner was just that. He was a fantastic teammate and a big-hearted, loving man. Very, very, when he played behind us, he was into it big time. There wasn't anybody more intense than Bill Buckner. And if you fans could see what we saw as players, for me as a young player, I would go to the locker room early to do my workouts. Bill Buckner was already at the stadium at 2 p.m. getting ready for a 7:35 game because basically he had bone rubbing on bone on his ankles. But he had to get ready to play for us and play well. This man could swing it. He could catch it and he could swing it. We love Billy Buckner and we appreciate everything he did. He will always be a winner in our hearts. So again, I thank you for this, guys. Thank you guys for doing this. I want to keep you. Thank you for my lovely wife of 30, almost 4 years, hanging with me and doing this with me and cheering us on to win ball games and doing all that stuff. She said I'm her fifth boy. I never want to grow up. I got a t-shirt that says, don't ever grow up. It's a trap. So I'll wear it forever. But love you, hon. Thanks for being here. Thanks for everybody that's here. Tip my hat to you guys in the dugout. Keep chasing your dreams. I tip my hat to all you guys. Hey, this game is not easy. As you guys know, I'm preaching to the choir. All your coaches, managers, you players on your way up to the big leagues, I wish you all the best. Stay healthy and just remember, this game is not easy. It takes a lot of focus and a lot of work. Thank you for having me.
He runs over to, I forgot his name, Indianapolis.
And now,
Pirates
folks,
player.
Your 2019 Pawtucket Red Sox will come out to offer their congratulations to the Rocket Man.
First pitch. This is going to be thrown by his longtime friend and Rhode Islander from Anthony's Jewelers, Anthony Manzo. He's going to throw a first pitch. From our Pawsox Hall of Famer himself to his longtime catcher, Rich Getman. We've got one final order of business to conclude our ceremonies. Our battery mates are going to get our ball game started with our two favorite sweet words presented by Honeydew Donuts. Here they are.
Play ball!
Roger Clemens, the 2019 inductee into the PawSox Hall of Fame. A lot of familiar faces. You can tell he was certainly excited for all the ceremonies and all the friends, former teammates, who came out to watch him here tonight at the ballpark. We've got first pitch coming up. We will take a timeout, and then we'll get you set for the ballgame. Roger Clemens into the PawSox Hall of Fame tonight at McCoy Stadium.